Welcome to another Petisco, a bite-sized chat about current topics. Today I'm joined by Carlos Ferreira, the owner and chef of one of Nazaré's best restaurants, Pangea. We discuss food in Portugal, Nazaré's best kept secret, and the recent launch of some incredible apartments with the best views in Nazaré. This Petisco is sponsored by Portugal Realty. Welcome back, or welcome to another episode of Portugal the Simple Life. This time we're having a petisco, so it's only appropriate that I'm joined by Carlos Ferreira. Carlos, welcome and thank you for joining us.
Hello, good morning. Nice to be talking to you.
Likewise. Carlos, I can see you're sitting in your chef's outfit there, and you're sitting at the restaurant. But yes, why don't you start off by telling us a little bit about yourself?
Well, I was born already in the hotel industry. Both my parents work in hotels when I was a young boy. So later on in my early 18s, let's say, I got married very young and I had to start working immediately. So I followed the steps of my father. My father was by then working on cruise ships, and so I followed. There was a lot of people. When you live in a place like Nazaré, a lot of people work on cruise ships and cargo ships because the fishing with the years started being a difficult thing. And at that time, there was still no port or anything. The boats were still going from the beach onto the sea. So a lot of people look for work on cruise ships and in cargo ships. And I did exactly the same I followed. Of course, with the years, you acquire a lot of experiences. You meet a lot of people. You see many different ways of doing things. And on the cruise ship is a big school. You learn it the hard way, but you do learn a lot of things that normal people would never acquire that experience. Because on a ship, if you work on a ship with 1,000 people, you have 1,000 guests 5 times a day to eat. So it's not like in land where things are complete. Even in a big hotel, things don't work that way. There, you have fixed customers, 1,000, 2,000, 3,000, today even 5,000 people. So, of course, the experience that you acquire, the ability to do, to be polyvalent, you know, to do many things at the same time.
Yeah, so polyvalent, for people listening, polyvalent is a fantastic Portuguese expression. The English translation would be a jack of all trades, someone that can do a little bit of everything. We say polyvalent in Portugal.
Yes.
But Carlos, let's take a step back quickly. Your village, your terra, is Nazaré.
Yes, I was born here in Nazaré. My father is from Lisbon, but my mom was from Nazaré, one of the old families of Nazaré. And even though I always been away from Nazaré from my early 17s, I always had house in Nazaré. So the holidays was always coming back home. You know, Nazaré it's difficult to explain. You know, it's something that you get very attached to it. It's part of our culture. We kind of think we're the best in the world. So we have the best town in the world. We have the best beach in the world, the best fish, and the best views. And it's we grow up like that. And it's intuitive into us. So we are very proud of being from this part of the world, you know.
You should be. You might be right about all of those things, but we'll talk a bit more about a few of these beautiful parts of Nazaré. Carlos, what did you miss when you were in Australia, when you were on the boats? What did you miss most about Portugal?
Probably the sense of security.
Okay.
You feel safe here, you know. Is a country without much crime. So you don't have to look back all the time. With my experience in many parts of the world, and I was lucky enough to visit the whole world. I did many, even world cruises. And the thing is, you are in beautiful places, but you still always have that sensation of non-security.
Mm-hmm.
Even in big countries like US, for example, you're always looking on the back to see who's behind you. Here, you don't have that. And that is probably something that I miss most, the sense of security, the sense of being safe. I think, in general, Portugal is very much like that. Of course, the customs, like Nazaré is very well known for Carnaval, for example. So it was always a period that always come to mind when you're not present. But yeah, this is probably the things that I miss most, apart from the family, of course.
Yeah. And Carlos, maybe tell us a little bit about Pangea, how it started, what you guys are doing. It's one of my, for me and my wife, it's one of our favorite restaurants. It has an amazing view, amazing food, amazing decor and interiors. You do traditional food, but with a modern twist, and the interior of the place is so comfortable, and just everything is fantastic. But tell us a little bit about Pangea.
Well, Pangea was a little bit of it came out from a conversation between my wife and our partner, Mr. Majek. He's a Polish citizen that loves Portugal. He's been here for a while now. And they were talking about, my wife was talking about opening something small with her sister. And he wanted to participate. So when he said he wanted to participate, then the small restaurant took a different proportion, okay? Because he had this house where Pangea is today, and therefore it was already a plus for us because we had a perfect spot to build this restaurant. And of course, the idea was developed from there. Less than a year later, we were opening the doors here. My wife, credit to her, because she did most of this all by herself, because I was still working on the cruise ships. I was by then working on sailing ships with Star Clippers. And I arrived here 1 month before we opened. My wife had done everything by herself. Yeah. And this is a credit to her, all the decoration, all the things that were chosen with her and her partner. And they did all the big decisions. My decision was to design the kitchen and prepare the menu. And that was about it on my side. Of course, I arrived here in June 2015. The 1st of June, I arrived in Portugal from a trip. And I start then searching for products that I intended to use in my menu. And it took me almost 6 weeks looking for the correct items and to try the menu, try all the dishes, make a team, because it was very difficult at that time. So I wanted people that was prepared to absorb all my ideas. And I was lucky to find a couple of young people that were recommended from hotel school in Alcobaça. We are now open 5.5 years, and we have managed to create a team of people that delivers what was our initial ideas, you know, what we intend to provide our guests with excellent service and good food without going too gourmet, to keep the traces of the region and the Portuguese culinary, but introducing some, I'd say, not adventurous, but, you know, to be a little bit, going a little bit out of the way of the tradition restaurants in Nazaré was a risk, because we are used to do almost everybody the same thing, but we took that risk, and today we can say that it was worthwhile, and the people appreciate that difference.
Yeah, I mean, the menu is superb. Yeah. I have to argue with you about some things. You were responsible for that dangerous dessert with the three chocolates.
Yes, also.
It's
actually, I have to say that my wife is the dessert chef. She makes most of the dessert. And for me, when we open, we have to find something that would make a difference, that people would say, I want to have this dish, let's go to Pangea. So we thought that octopus, I knew that I could cook octopus to the point, to the perfection, which is a very item that is not easy to cook. Most places where I used to go, and I am a lover of octopus, I used to eat octopus everywhere. But, you know, was too mushy, too overcooked, or not cooked enough. So we decide that this would be our speciality of the Pangea. And has been a big success. This dish you see here now is our globe, Pangea globe. It has a design of the world of Pangea. And inside of this globe, we serve a trilogy of octopus. And this has been a huge success for us.
It's amazing.
Very glad that we make that decision, and has worked for us. Yes.
Well, that was going to be my next thing to talk to you about your menu, because the octopus, I love it. When I feel like a good polvo, I think Pangea. I have to go to Pangea. And the other one that you do really nicely and in a different way, I think, like you were saying, you take a traditional concept and you make it a little bit different, is your bacalhau. Bacalhau is available everywhere in Nazaré, everywhere in Portugal, but yours is something special with that broa, with that crust. It's really delicious. So, yeah, the food is amazing, and we can't wait to come back.
Thank you. We took the option that everything we do here in terms of fish or seafood, nothing has bones, including the bacalhau. So bacalhau is normally a dish that you can make it in many different ways, and you can, but it always has a lot of bones in it. So we decide to serve only the lombo, which is the richest part of, and the highest part of the cod fish, and we do it without any bones. Of course, it is a tradition to have bacalhau with broa. So broa is the cornbread that we use a lot here in Portugal. And therefore, we decide to make our version of the bacalhau com broa. Of course, no bones in it. It's something that you can just put your fork through it and put in your mouth and not worry about any bones in it.
I'm getting hungry. My stomach is starting to make noises. Carlos, stop. It's that bacalhau is so good. But we've got something very lucky in Portugal, I think, and maybe you can comment about this, is the quality of the ingredients, the quality of the product, the quality of the fish. How much of a pleasure is it to cook with these kind of ingredients?
This is fantastic. We are in a zone that, in an area here in the center of Portugal, that it has a lot of fresh produce. Of course, apart from the fresh fish that being in Nazaré, you can easily get it, fish and seafood, but the fresh of the fruit and vegetables here is unbelievable. And most of it is biologic, because people don't treat much the land, especially people from here. I buy my a lot of my produce from a lady of Pedernera. She's from this area here. If you look from Pedernera down to the beach, in between Pedernera and the beach, there is a lot of land that has been the people uses for agriculture. So all those small pieces of land there, very well designed, belong to many different people. They all have a small piece of it. And I buy most of my things from this lady, and she's a local lady, and this is andouri. This is something that you put in the water, you cook it for a few seconds, and it's done. You don't need to cook it a long time because it's so tender, it's so fresh, that and the flavors make a difference, yes. So we are lucky in that sense. We have a lot of also meat not far from here, as far as maybe 60 kilometers from here, is an area, Torres Novas, with very good meat. So, yes, we are lucky to be in an area that offers all those produces that normally you would have to go to the big cities to get. Here we get it right at our door. It's unbelievable.
Yeah, well, one of the reasons that we are having this conversation is we're launching a property in Pedernera, brand new apartments. And when you spoke about Nazaré has the best views in the world, these apartments have got the best view in Nazaré. And they're right next door to Pedernera's Miradouro, the lookout point of Pedernera. So very close to the restaurant, so people can walk from the apartments to your restaurant. It's wonderful. But for people listening, just tell us a bit about Pedernera. What makes this place so special? It's a bit of a hidden secret in Nazaré. Yes. What makes it such a special place?
We normally say that Pedernera is the poor brother of Nazaré. Okay. So even though Pedernera was the beginning of the whole thing, Pedernera was for Nazaré was first Pedernera. Nazaré did not exist. It was the Bay of Pedernera. And the place where my restaurant is, which is the Miradouro of Misericordia, is already from the 15th century. So this has been here a long, long time. They used to call it the Bay of Pedernera.
And not because the water used to come right up to Pedernera.
Much higher, yes.
So Nazaré, as we know it, was in those days was covered in water.
Most of it, yes.
Yeah, amazing.
So here, most of the people worked the land, and they were fishermen at the time. And today, most of the people work still in agriculture and in construction. A lot of people work in construction. But Pedernera is a very quiet area of Nazaré. It's not, you don't get that big confusion of the summer that you get down by the sea. Here is like, you come up here and you can observe all of it. So Pedernera is full of still small streets made of stone where you can explore all the small we call it ruas here in English.
Yeah, the little streets.
Streets. They're not lanes. Streets. They you walk between the houses and the fountains, and you still have a lot of Roman history around Pedernera, and therefore, once you get to this Miradouro here, you can observe. Normally, Nazaré has always been sold as a part of the pictures that you normally used to see. They were all taken from Sitio. And Sitio also is a very beautiful place, of course, it's part of Nazaré. And but when you actually look from Pedernera, you can actually see Sitio, which is not normal. So you can see all that Tencos and the fort at the end of the cliff, and the whole beach in front of you. So this is an amazing, in terms of views, I think we have the privilege to have a better view than anybody else from Nazaré, from the beach. So
the view is incredible. I mean, that I know that the Midadoru, the Misericordia, the lookout point of Pradaneta, I know it was voted as one of the best lookout points in the whole of Portugal. And I'll actually tell you a little story. I have some clients. They were from the Netherlands. A few years back, he said to me, I need the perfect place to propose to my wife. And he proposed to his wife on the lookout point. And after he had dinner in your restaurant, and he said it was the perfect night. The views are amazing. You can see everything. But what I also like about Pradaneta, Carlos, is it feels like it's still old world.
500 years ago. Huh?
Yeah, because it hasn't changed. It's got the little roads, the cobblestone streets, the statues, the church. It's beautiful.
It's like if you go to the Azores. Huh? When you compare Madeira Island with the Azores, it's the same with Pradaneta and Nazaré. It's you can go back in time here. And the silence, you know, the silence here is unbelievable. You walk here and you don't hear much noise at all. You can hear the sea on the beach makes like a echo up here. And the whole area here behind me was just redone. The council just did the whole area of the Miradouro and the whole new road around here. And it's modern, but it kept all the old lines that it had before. So, but it's quite nice to have here. And we have a lot more people visiting today, Pradaneta. Of course, the investments that were done here in Pradaneta in the last years. And we are happy to have been part of that investment and that progress. And I'm sure that with time, it will become more and more movement around town. Hopefully without spoiling anything. Very, very nice the way it is.
Carlos, what do you want to say about the people of Pradaneta? Well, tell us about the people that live there.
It's not much difference from Nazaré people. Of course, here you always have a little bit of a rivalry between Sítio Nazaré and Pradaneta. And if you look into the songs of Carnival, you can feel that those differences there. But of course, we all belong to the same family, let's say. But people are very, very serious, very helpful. They are hard workers. They very sincere. They open their hearts to everybody, even if they don't never see them in their lives. And in general, Nazaré, and Nazaré City and Pradaneta, when I say Nazaré, it includes everybody. We know how to receive. We receive very well. We've been, I think, all our life, we were placed in that direction of serving people, of receiving people from other parts of Portugal and from the other parts of the world. I am 60 now, but I remember to be a young boy playing on the beach, and you could hear already different languages, you know, the English, the French, the Swedish. A lot of people used to come to Nazaré and continue. And I tell you a story. I was back in 1979 when I first embarked. I went to Australia, and the following year, 1980, I went to the States for the first time. I went to join a cruise ship, and I joined that ship in San Francisco, in the U.S. And I was with a group of friends. We were just walking in the city, and we stopped in front of a travel agency, and the picture was a lady of Nazaré showing her seven skirts. And it said, Portugal, where the sun shines 360 years days a year in a year. Okay, of course, I was a very young man at that time, 18 years old. I was like in tears, missing my hometown. And already then, Nazaré back in the 80s, early 80s, was already showing Portugal to the world. So we are very proud of that. And we receive well. People comes here. There is a lot of people living here now from other countries. And I'm sure they feel that sense of security and welcome that we present them with, for sure.
Wonderful. Carlos, I would like to, I'm going to, in the show notes of this podcast, I'm going to put a link for people to follow the restaurant and to get in touch, and for people, people need to go and eat there. It's amazing. We're also going to put links for people to know more about these beautiful apartments that are going to be in Padaneda and to see more about Padaneda, because it's really a special place in Nazaré. But I have a very simple question for you, because this is a petisco. We call this a petisco. It's a bite-sized episode. What is your favorite petisco?
My favorite petisco, octopus.
easy answer.
It's true. I would not have it as a speciality if it wasn't. I really, from when I was very young, I have a lot of family that were fishermen, and even today I have cousins that fish octopus here in Israel. Right? And I have to say octopus.
Easy. I should have known.
Just simple, boiled, a little bit of olive oil, a little bit of garlic and onions, parsley, and a little bit of vinegar or balsamic vinegar, and that's it. Simple as that.
Wonderful. Carlos, thank you so much. Forza.
Thank you.
Abraço, and I will see you soon.
Thank you very much. Thank you for having us. And we'll be very pleased that you sell all those beautiful apartments and that we get all those new guests here into our restaurant. Abraço. Ciao.
So thank you once again to Carlos, and thank you to all of you for listening. Please subscribe. Share with your friends, give us a thumbs up, and please leave a comment or a review. We'd love to hear from you. And follow the links available for more information about Pangea, Nazaré's best kept secret, Padaneda, and the phenomenal Sunset View apartments. Welcome to the simple life.